Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is V. Please subscribe. So this is how I make money online, and trust me, I make a living out of it. Don't be lied, guys. Working online really, really pays, and trust me, you can make a living out of it. Anyway, so today I'm taking you guys through some of the tips that I learned, and also encourage someone out there. I've had so many friends who want to do online writing, and you know, guys, it involves a lot, and I can't really summarize everything in a text. So I decided to do this video just to answer all your questions. And also, if you're an aspiring writer out there, if you are aspiring to become to work online, that is, do freelancing or blogging or such things, then these tips might really help you. It has worked for me. It has really worked for me. And I think I might really help somebody out there. So first, let's just go straight into the video. If you see me looking down, I have a book here. I've written a few things so that I can go in step by step and not miss out on anything. So first, when you want to do writing and you are a beginner, you don't have any skills, you don't even know where to get clients from, you don't know where to get jobs from. Trust me, I was there, I didn't even know where to start. So first, what you need to know before you can begin this whole thing is be patient. It involves a lot of patience. Trust me, you are new in this and everything takes time. So trust me, you need patience. Of course, because you might be working and not earning at the same time, you need patience so that you can grow your space, you can get clients to trust you with their work, and that is how you'll get long-term contracts. So just be patient and don't worry, everything will work out. The second point is plan your time wisely. You know, by planning your time, that is how you'll meet deadlines, because you know, at times you'll really work for almost 24 hours. This time, I just sat for a whole 24 hours just working. You need to plan your time. Remember, if you have a schedule, it will probably be disrupted by everything, because you need to deliver, you need to work, and you're given specific deadline, you're given specific number of days, or even if it's hours, you need to deliver it within that time. Always remember to meet your deadlines. That's another thing. Meet your deadlines. So if you're given like a week, or if you're given a few days, submit it before the deadline. That's another way of retaining a client. Because if you get late, then that's a whole story. It might not really go well with your schedule, because at times you'd work like the whole night, then you decide to sleep, and then the client comes back informing you, I need some changes. Then you have to like work on it again. So these are just a few tips that you need to know before you can indulge into this. So for me, before, I was like, I used to have friends who do this online thing, and then I used to tell them, this work is so easy, it's just like a normal assignment you do in campus. Trust me, it's not easy, because when you do, you know, these are clients paying, so they need like professional work, and you need to do it the way they want it. It's not easy guys, honestly, it's not easy. But once you decide to do it, you can do it. Because I was once there, I was a beginner, I didn't have any skills, I didn't know even where to start from. But now I can say I pay my bills working online. The other point is be professional. You know, once you're professional about exactly what you do and how you communicate with the client, then the client will automatically trust you with their work. What you need to know first before you can even decide to join the online platform, before you can decide to work online, don't have a desperate mindset. Don't be desperate in any way. You know, online is just like any other work out there, because when you look desperate, then the person will exploit you. When you tell the client, I need this and this cash, be professional about it. Don't sound desperate. You know, the client will give you a very low price. And some even, there are some who can pay you 1,000 That is $10 for 1,000 words. Come on, guys. That is slavery, man. That is like, that is way too low. Remember, you're not the only writer out there. There's so many people. So you need to have like a strong profile. Have like, explain what you do. If you're a content writer, then explain it so well. If you are a if you do transcription, have a strong profile. Also, for Upwork and for any other account, you need to like send a proposal. You need to like send a message after placing your prize. Send the client a message explaining what specifically you do. For me, when I joined, I guess it was luck. I decided to start with Upwork. And through that, you know, Upwork is works with luck. So you can be bidding for jobs day in, day out for a whole year, and you might end up not even getting a job. But for me, I opened my Upwork like today, and the next day I had a job. I guess it was luck. Trust me, guys. It took me time before I can actually say I earned cash from online. It really took me time. I took a whole, my first cash. You guys, imagine, I worked for a whole 2 months, and guess what? The amount of cash I earned within the whole 2 months was $100. For a whole 2 months. Remember, you've been working. You've been really, really working. Also, decline jobs at times. Don't just take any other. Don't take jobs because I know you are broke. You are jobless and you don't have any other thing to do. But also, if you decide to just take up a job, and remember, this is working online and it really takes a lot of time. It takes a lot of effort, a lot of mind work, and you're going to like really get tired doing this. I do academic work, academic research and all that, and that is why I decided to go with Upwork, because it's affordable and it's actually friendly beginner. It's beginner friendly. If you don't have any skills, you can decide to start with that, but it goes with luck, trust me. Upwork. And there's also Fiverr. I've heard of Fiverr. I don't know the others, but for me, I decided to go with Upwork, and I can actually say it worked so well for me, because after I got my first job, my first gig, like the next day, after like 2 days, I got another one, and this second one was really paying me so well, and through that, and also when you decide to work online, do it with one heart. Like, do it like, you know, going, you know, just do it well, because clients will keep on coming back to you if your work is good. So the second client I got, the first one was just a one-time project, but the second person who gave me work was a long-term contact. So I worked for that person the whole time, like for about a whole month. So the other point, guys, is invest your money. You know, when you're starting off, this is like any other business. This is just basically like any other business. You need to invest your money in it. You have to like buy a website. You have to maybe buy an account. Of course, for Upwork, you have to buy Connect. So you have to invest your money in order to bring money in. So you have to buy something called Connect. It's like, I don't know how to explain. These are things you can't bid for a job. You can't propose for a job if you don't have Connect. You have to buy them. Because this is just like any other business. It pays bills. This is business and it pays bills. You don't even have to worry about anything. As long as you do good, as long as you do a good job, you will earn a lot of cash and you'll keep on getting more and more contacts coming your way. But the good thing about writing is, if you get like about 4 clients or even 2, you can go a long way. Especially if the 2 clients have like a long-term contact. The last point I'd tell you guys is, be ready to take risks. You know, this is like any other business, of course. So you'll be working with clients all over the world. You really don't know them. And at times, most of them can even decide not to pay. So you have to take risks. You have to be ready for anything. Just work and do your best. These are just some of the tips I learned throughout. And what I can say is, how I earn is just directly. I started with accounts and then moved on to other accounts. And also, I do direct pitching. I also work with clients directly. You have to build a good profile and communicate well. By doing so, you'll have longer clients and you'll have retained contacts. So these are just some of the tips. I might do episode 2 on this, guys, so stay tuned. And please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I guess this is where we end the vlog. You can ask me questions in the comment section of what you'd want me to explain in the next video. And yeah, feel free. I'll answer every other question. And also, please subscribe if you haven't already. Subscribe to my channel, guys. It's free. And somebody asked me if subscribing is free, guys. It's free. All you have to do is click subscribe, hit the bell so that you get notified whenever I post. Like my video. Share if you have a friend who's aspiring to become a writer, or if you have if you have groups, you can share this video so that they can check it out. I'll have an episode 2 of this, so watch out for that. And thank you, guys. Thank you so far. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell, comment, like the video, comment and share.